Okay, see here, now we are going to see today's solution of linear equations in two variables. The first question is the linear equation 2x minus 5y is equal to 7 has how many solutions? A unique solution, infinitely many solutions, two solutions or no solutions, okay? So your answer is infinitely many solutions, okay? Why answer? Because if you will take here 1, okay, if x is equal to 1, that time you will get y is equal to different value. If x is equal to 2, y is equal to anything different, or y is equal to 1, that time x is different. Okay, like that many values you will get. So answer is infinitely many solutions. Second question is, which of the following represents a line parallel to y axis? Okay, which of the following is represents line parallel to y axis? Okay, so from that, answer C is correct. Answer C is correct. Okay. Why? See carefully. Here there is only one variable, 4x minus x. Okay. If you will solve this, then you will get here 4x minus 3 is equal to x plus 1. So 4x, this minus x is equal to 1 plus 3. So 3x is equal to 4. So x is equal to 4 by 3. Which of the following represents a line parallel to y-axis? Here only value of x is 4 by 3, so y-coordinate will be 0. Y-coordinate will be 0. Okay, so this is parallel to the y-axis. Next question is question number 3. If 2, 0 is a solution of the linear equation 2x plus 3y is equal to k, then the value of k is. Okay, so here we have to put 0. 2 into 0. 2 plus 3, 2 into 2, value of x is 2, 2 into 2 is 4 plus 0, so k is equal to 4, k is equal to 4, so this answer is A. Then question number 4, any solution of the linear equation 2x plus 0y plus 9 is equal to 0 in two variables is of the form, answer is A here, okay, because this is 0. So finally x is equal to this plus 9 will move that side minus 9. So x is equal to minus 9 by 2. Okay. And this will be y coordinate, that is m, it is taken. Understood? Here it is taken at the place of y, but this is value of x. So A is the correct answer. Question number 5 is C, if C is equal to S plus 3T, then the value of T when C is equal to 3 by 5 and S is equal to 1 by 10. Okay. So you can solve this. C equals to S plus 3T. So C is equal to, you can put 3 by 5 is equal to S is 1 by 10 plus 3T. So you will take this side 3 upon 5 minus 1 by 10. So you will multiply here by 2, here also by 2 is equal to 3T. So 6 minus 1 by 10 is equal to 3T. 6 minus 1 is 5 by 10 is equal to 3T. So 3 will come this side. T is equal to this 5 by 10 means what? 1 by 2. This 3 will come and here we need to multiply. So 1 by 6. Okay, 1 by 6. So which one is option correct? B is the correct option here. Now question number 6. The graph of the linear equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 6 cuts at y axis at the point. Here answer is D, 0, 2. Because if you put here 0, 2 into 0, 0, 3 into 2, 6. Okay, cut the y axis. Understood? So D is the correct answer. When you take 0, 2, that time the equation will be satisfied. Question number 7C. The equation x is equal to 7 in two variables can be written in x is equal to. So here answer is B. Why B? See carefully. X is equal to 7. So here you will take 7. 7, 0 point y means this answer is 0. 0 into y. Point means 0 multiplied by y. So here 7 equals to 7. So B is the correct answer. Question number 8. Any point on the x axis is of the form. X axis is of the form. So which answer will come? C, x0. Its y coordinate will be 0. Question number 9. Y is equal to any point on the line y is equal to x is of the form. Y is equal to x is of the form. That answer is A. Because both the values are same. Y and x values are same. Question number 10. The equation of x axis is of the form. X axis is of the form. That is b y is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0. Understood? X axis, so y coordinate is 0. Then question number 11. Question number 11 is equal to the point of the form a by 2 always lies on the line. Okay, see here, this is x coordinate and this is y coordinate, and x coordinate is 2 times of y coordinate, or y coordinate is half of a. Understood? So which equation is satisfying this b? X coordinate is 2 times of y, so this equation is satisfying. Question number 12. X is equal to 5, y is equal to 2 is the solution of the linear equation. Is the solution of the linear equation. Question number x is equal to 5, so answer is C. Here answer is C, because 5 plus 2 is 7. Okay, next question number 13. Question number 13 is, if a linear equation has solution minus 2, 2, 0, 0, 2, minus 2, then it is of the form of, it is of the form of x plus y is equal to 0. X plus y is equal to 0. Okay, because minus 2 plus 2, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 2 minus 2, 0. Okay. Then next question is, the positive solution of the equation ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 lie in the first quadrant, because in first quadrant both x coordinate and y coordinate both are always positive. Understood? So now here question number 15. Question number 15 is, the graph of the linear equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 6 is a line which meets the x-axis at the point. Okay, just we have to put the value. So D is the correct answer. See here, 2 3 is a 6 and 3 into 0, 0. So this is satisfying equation. Understood? If we multiply or divide both sides of linear equation with a non-zero number, then the solution of the linear equation. Okay, if we divide or multiply, then remains same. We have seen. Then the solution of the equation x by 2 plus x by 3 is equal to 5. Make denominator same. Here you will multiply by 3. Here 2. So 3x plus 2x, 5x and 6 5 is 30. So x is equal to b. 6 is the answer correct. The linear equation 5x minus 2y. Linear equation 5x minus, this is equation in two variables. So infinitely many solutions. 19. Any point on the y-axis is of the form, y-axis is of the form b, 0y. Okay, its x coordinate will be 0. Question number 20. The equation 2x plus y is equal to 4 has a unique solution if x and y are natural numbers. Okay, are natural numbers. Any natural number you can take here, any natural numbers only you can use here. So 2, then only you will get RHS same. So natural numbers is the correct answer. Then backside, an equation of the form of ax plus by plus c where a, b, c are real numbers such that a, b are not both 0 is called a linear equation. This is linear. Okay, a linear equation in two variable can have dash solutions, infinitely many solutions, because values are depend on each other. X value is different, that time y will get different. When y is different, x is, you will get different. Okay, so infinitely many. Then question number 3. This graph of every linear equation in two variables is a straight line. Graph is getting a straight line. Then question number 4. The graph of x is equal to a is a straight line parallel to the y axis. Okay, when you will get any x is equal to value of x, that time y is 0. So it will be parallel to the y axis. The same thing, the graph of y is equal to a is a straight line parallel to the x-axis, vice versa. Okay, then question number 7. Equation of x-axis, that time y coordinate is 0, that is y is equal to 0. Okay, and equation of y-axis, that time x is equal to 0. Question number 9c. The line 2x plus 3y is equal to 6 cuts the x, here two things will come. Okay, so first 3 0 or 0 2. See here, 3 0 means here if you will take 3, 3 2 is a 6, and here y is 0, so it will be 0. So 6 is equal to 6. In second pair, 0 2 is given. 0 2 we can use. So here 0 and 3 to the 6. So two pairs are going to come 30 and 02. Next, question number 10. The linear equation 3x minus y is equal to x minus y has infinitely many solutions. Okay, because linear equation in two variables. Question number 11. The line parallel to y axis at a distance a units to the left of y axis is given by the equation x left of y axis a units. Left of y axis means definitely on this is negative numbers. So suppose minus a is here. So that will come minus a, negative numbers, left of y axis. Then question, sorry, this is here. Question number 12. If x is equal to 4, then this line is parallel to the y axis. This line x is equal to 4, that time y is equal to 0. So it definitely this will come parallel to the y axis. And last question, if the point minus 2, 2 lies on the line ax plus 4y is equal to 2, then a. Put the values a into minus 2 plus 4 into 2 is equal to 2. So minus 2a is equal to 4, 2s are 8, will go that side, minus 8. So 2 minus 8 is minus 6, minus a is equal to 2, 3 is a 6. So a is equal to 3. Okay. So this was a very easy paper. Thank you very much and best of luck for tomorrow's test. Thanks once again.